Power star and legend Dr. Rajkumar's son, Puneet Rajkumar, has passed away, leaving his fans and the Kannada film industry in absolute shock. Puneet was a fitness enthusiast who ran marathons. He was rushed to Vikram Hospital this morning, right after he complained of chest pain and uneasiness. As the news broke of his death, fans, co-stars mobbed the hospital there. Statewide outpouring of grief. Very, very sad news coming in from Karnataka. Here's a look.
Karnataka superstar Puneet Rajkumar dies of cardiac arrest. The 46-year-old actor's sudden death has left his legion of fans in utter shock. The power star of Karnataka was rushed to the Vikram Hospital in Bengaluru around 11:40 Friday morning, where he breathed his last. Puneet Rajkumar collapsed at a gym around 8 this morning while working out. The actor was taken to the Raman Shri Hospital around 11 after complaining of chest pain and discomfort. The doctors said that the actor had a severe cardiac arrest. He was then rushed to the Vikram Hospital. Puneet was unresponsive by the time he reached the Vikram Hospital, according to a statement released by doctors. He was declared dead at 2:30 p.m. after doctors' efforts to revive the superstar for almost 3 hours at the hospital's intensive care unit failed. Puneet Rajkumar donated his eyes.
We made all immediate cardiac resuscitation was initiated. By that we mean advanced cardiac resuscitation, that is cardiac massage, defibrillation, that is a shock therapy. And the patient was even put on a ventilator, and all other medications to try and revive his heart were administered. In spite of that, patient continued to be non-responsive and was also the heart disc did not refuse to pick up.
Thousands of his fans thronged the hospital after the tragic news spread. The actor's mortal remains were taken to his Sadashiv Nagar residence, where his fans gathered to catch a last glimpse of their beloved hero. The actor's remains will be placed for public viewing on Saturday at a stadium amidst massive security arrangements.
It is his fans. They are the true people who actually would want to come and pay their last respects, and that would happen right at this particular place. And you can clearly see they have kept a separate place for the media over there, and beyond that where his coffin will be placed, so that his fans, I don't know how many of them, and there are thousands or there are lakhs, will actually come together or right over here.
Expecting that a large number of people would be coming here, we have been making all the arrangements, and we will be able to accommodate all the people who would be coming here for his darshan or to have the glimpses of the last glimpses of the body.
The industry is mourning the loss of a young superstar.
We've lost somebody, a big brother, we've lost a family member, we've lost somebody that we all looked up to, and we must continue making quality cinema and living in that goals of making a better industry that Appu sir always believed in.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who is in Italy to attend the G20 summit, paid his respects on social media. He said coming generations will remember Puneet fondly for his works and wonderful personality. Condolences are pouring in after the actor's sad and untimely demise.
Very good actor, and it is very great loss, not only in the film field, not only in other field, entire country.
Even now also, in our heart actually, he is with us. But it is unbelievable development today, that sad demise.
Puneet comes from a family of Kannada stars. He is the son of the legendary actor, Dr. Rajkumar. The sandalwood industry's king has left the world too soon. With Nolan Pinto in Bengaluru, Bureau Report, India Today.
Right, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said cruel twist of fate has really snatched away a young, very talented, extraordinary human being. Puneet Rajkumar is no more. I have with me some of the panelists joining us to give an insight into how they remember Puneet Rajkumar, an actor par excellence, a human being extraordinary. Sharmila Mandre joining us, an actor herself. Indrajit Lankesh, a film director joining us. Parul Yadav, who's an actor herself. We also have Vivek Mahajan, who's an international cardiologist with Fortis Hospital. Let me quickly cut across to Nolan Pinto before that. Nolan, take us through exactly what you see at the Kantirava Stadium. We understand that the entire Karnataka cabinet, the chief minister, along with his ministers, are currently present at Kantirava Stadium to bid final goodbye. But the cremation will not take place today. We believe that the family is waiting for Puneet's daughter to come back or come down from the United States, and that will take place on Sunday morning. Take us through the details of it, please, and show us what's behind you.
Nabila, we have been here since about 5 in the evening, and we've seen how the preparations were actually done over here, the measures being put in place by the government as well as the police. Now, one can really say that they have done a fabulous job. Fans were allowed in, say, about half an hour ago, and I'm showing you those visuals as of now. You can see, I think just from the entrance to the time they can actually pay their last respects to his body, maybe about 5,000 at any particular point of time are there. And what we are told, in fact, the commissioner of police, when I spoke to him, he says that his fans who are coming from across the state will be able to come here, pay their last respects throughout the night, tomorrow the entire day, and mostly till midnight. And like you rightly stated, the final rites will take place with full state honours. Chief Minister Basavaraj Bommai stated that outside the hospital. But they are waiting for his daughter to arrive in the city, and that can only happen on Sunday morning. This is the information we are getting. But it's also nice to see, you can clearly see there, I hope from the visuals, the Chief Minister, a few of his cabinet colleagues, also personalities from Sandalwood, and various other, even opposition leaders, are all sitting over there with the family members. So this is what is happening. A large number of people coming here very, very decently. There is no problem at all. Extremely peaceful. But the police have taken care. In fact, as of now, there are 6,000 police personnel stationed across the city. In this particular place, some 40-odd KSRP platoons have been deployed, along with the City Armed Reserve and the Rapid Action Force. The police believe that they have put in place all sorts of measures and things should go in properly, but a very, very sad day indeed.
This time, a sea of fans, supporters coming in from all across Karnataka, different parts of Karnataka, they've come down to the Kantirava Stadium. That itself shows the kind of clout and the influence that Puneet Rajkumar had with the people of Karnataka. Of course, because of the kind of contribution he's given, his family has given, they're known as the first family of Kannada film industry for their contribution, immense contribution to the Kannada language, the Kannada culture. That's the affection we see in the form of fans coming in large numbers at the Kantirava Stadium. It's overwhelming crowds there. No wonder why the state government decided that Kantirava Stadium is the apt place for the final goodbye for Puneet Rajkumar. Of course, our guests here joining us, let me cut across. We also have Manjunath, Master Manjunath, who is an actor himself, who's been a child artist just like Puneet Rajkumar. Let me cut across to our panelists there. Manjunath, over to you. Absolutely saddened with what we see here, the news that we hear of Puneet Rajkumar. It's still so hard for us to digest that fact. The man was super talented, that apart. He was such a fitness freak. It's so difficult to believe that Puneet Rajkumar, who woke up every morning to do his workouts, would eat clean, ensure that he had a diet and a strict fitness regime that he would follow regularly. Hail or storm, the man followed his fitness to the T. A person like that, a great human being, we lost so soon. How would you remember Puneet Rajkumar today?
No, you know, it's we are all in shock. I mean, I you know, it's unbelievable. We're all flabbergasted, and it's indeed a cruel twist of fate. The Kannada film industry, Karnataka, India's lost a great talented actor, and most importantly, as you rightly pointed out, a very, very good human being. He was my peer. He was just, a year older to me. I've literally followed in his footpath, in his path. And You know, it's very difficult to digest, and it's very difficult to express in words the kind of loss we are all feeling, and especially me.
Well, your stint from Malgudi days, Manjunath, you were a child artist, you essayed Swami. Puneet itself, he himself won a national award as a child. You all have grown together. What was the kind of bond you shared? And if there's one takeaway memory of Puneet Rajkumar, what would that be?
Absolutely. So we spent about 14 days together in the International Children's Film Festival in Bhuvaneshwar, and he had won the award the previous year, and we shared a room, and it was one of the most wonderful experience of my life. He was so supportive, and when I won the international award, he was so happy, and I was like really blessed and glad that he was there with me because I was very young. And being from the first family of Kannada film industry, he was absolutely supportive, you know, would guide me, would call me, would, you know, share a lot of information, and he would openly express his appreciation, which is such a great thing and such an honor. And it is really, really, absolutely devastating loss to us, because he has not only nurtured me, he was nurturing tremendous talent across Kannada film industry.
He's groomed number of stars under his wing, not because he is Dr. Rajkumar's son. That's because his personality was such. He was such a giving person, a person who would always appreciate talent, who would recognize talent.
Absolutely
the kind of
humble.
Yeah.
Absolutely humble, very, you know, humility, and just like his dad. And I would like to say this because his dad was like that, and it was like when we had interacted with his dad, and when we interacted with him, at least for me, it was like, my God, I mean, it's just flowed down to him. And it is really, God is really unkind. And
shattering news, Manjunath. I understand. I believe, just gotten out of his house. I want to know how his family is doing. But I'm going to quickly cut across to Ramesh Arvind, who is a great star himself in Karnataka. Mr. Arvind, here is a colleague, a friend, a family member of yours, I'm assuming, because none can ignore Appu. He's such a great human being. He instantly can become a family member of yours if you really know him, because he leaves a lasting impression. The kind of image that he's held on through his career, despite being a star son, no airs of himself, absolutely grounded and rooted to the Kannada culture and the language. Very few do you see gems like that in the state of Karnataka today. Ramesh Arvind, your memory of Putta. I hear that you've chatted with Puneet Rajkumar just last night for about 2 hours. Is that right?
It's crazy. Yesterday we were in a friend's birthday party. I walk in at 8:45. Appu comes at 9:45. We are stuck with each other till 11:15. Me, my wife, Appu and Ashwini, his wife. We were talking about so many things. He was opening about so many things. He was showing about his dream project, which he had taped. He took me to the balcony and showed me his mobile. He said, "Sir, this is what I've done. I want to show it." And he showed me something that he had done about forests in Karnataka. And he had some dream about it. We were talking about our own domestic things and about our daughters and sons. And he was so warm. So there was not even the smallest signal that this man is not going to be with us tomorrow. Morning, I get up. The news I hear is that Appu is no more. It's one of the biggest shocks I've ever faced.
Where did you meet him, Mr. Arvind? Did you meet him at his home? Was he at yours?
No.
Were you at an event last night?
No, we have a common friend by name Guru Kiran, who's a music director.
Yeah.
It was his birthday yesterday. So Guru had hosted a party for a small group of friends.
Okay.
And then we were there, and you know, he just put us, four of us in one corner. We were talking, and there was Anirudh there. There was Rachita Ram, there were a few of us. And we were just chatting away to glory, you know. And then the morning this news comes, you know how it can be, right? I mean, you've been with that guy just last evening, talking, chatting, eating together. And next day, he's not there. And I know the entire family from a long time. Appu's a guy. If you meet Appu once, you will like him lifelong.
Yeah.
That's the kind of guy he was. He was a very, very sweet person. Very simple, very, very down to earth. Extremely talented, amazing dancer. Great at stunts. great with people, you know, talking to people, opening up to people, honestly connecting with people. He had one of the greatest smiles you will come across. One of the most honest smiles you will see.
It's just such a loss, a personal loss to me as well, because I know through my career as a journalist myself, the amount of encouragement and appreciation that Puneet has given me, I'd really like to put this on record. I mean, for the kind of the words that he uses, just that those encouraging words can take you a long way. And he does that not just with friends, but anyone, including a spot boy on a set, going and giving him a hug, asking a light boy or a spot boy how his day is, having a nice meal with them. You'd seldom see stars of his stature be so grounded.
Even yesterday, when he left the party, he made it a point to talk to the other drivers, say goodbye to them and say bye. He came driving himself, I guess, yesterday. And then he told me, sir, I always take my daughter for a drive in the car before I sleep. So I got to go back home, take her for a drive. That's what he said and left.
Yeah, he loved cars. He had a great fancy for cars. Oh, it's just unbelievable. I'm not able to fathom the loss. And I'm sure lakhs of fans there who've stormed the Kantirwa Stadium. We believe there is a huge crowd there. Nolan Pindo is bringing us visuals. You get to see the visuals right on your screens here. You have Basaraj Bommai, R. Ashok, the entire cabinet there, in fact, who's present there bidding final goodbye. Of course, the formal cremation with state honours will be done only on Sunday, possibly. That's day after. Because his daughter is still in the United States. She's taking an urgent flight and she will be landing only on Sunday. And that's when the funeral will happen. But here, Puneet Rajkumar's body has been placed inside Kantirwa Stadium because anticipating the crowd that will land up. And clearly, you see the kind of people. You already have the Chief Minister and other Cabinet Ministers, Ashwath Narayan as well, who's present right there. Let me cut across to Sharmila Mandre, who's also been quite successful in the industry, in the Kannada film industry. You surely would have come across Appu, isn't it, Sharmila? What's your memory of Puneet? A fitness freak. That's what we're finding it hard to believe, that he's a fitness enthusiast, a man who's so focused around his workouts and his regime. We lost him so soon.
The thing is, Naveela, I must say that I have met him on multiple occasions, be it in film events and, of course, being in the industry for so many years as well. Myself, I have met him on multiple occasions. And today, when I got to know, it was not just the loss of a superstar, but it was a loss of a person who was so humble. And his personality was so sort of, it was amazing to see a person who was like that, you see. And I was I was like so happy to see somebody like that being so humble. Usually, you know, you probably think a star would not have that kind of they probably have, you know, airs and stuff like that. But he was so humble. And today when I got to know, I was like, you know, life can be so unpredictable. Yeah. And it was truly a shock to me. And I'm sure it is to everybody, the entire industry.
It is. It absolutely is. I'd like to really remember...
When I'm listening to you and I'm having this, you know, and I'm at this panel, I can't even believe, I'm still like, it's still kind of sinking in that this can actually sort of happen, you know.
A time so when you've crossed paths with him, Sharmila, that you really remember, a conversation that you've possibly had with him that has left a lasting memory for you, a takeaway that you would remember Puneet for.
So actually, I have worked with Shivana, that's his brother, Shivraj Kumar. Yeah. And we were at a music launch of the film and I had just finished performing and I'd come to meet him actually. And we were just having a discussion about, films and stuff. And then he said, what are you doing next? So I said, sir, you know, I don't know. I want to do a couple of films, which I think are right, but I'm still deciding and stuff like that. So he said, he's like, let me just give you a piece of advice. You should always do films that you're truly passionate about and something that sort of makes you want to believe in it and not just do films for the sake of, you know, just because, you know, you feel the need to be in the pressure of quantity films rather than. So he's like, he always told me to choose quality over quantity and I could never ever forget
that. And that was Appu, right? He often had so much substance in his films. I mean, apart from,
absolutely,
of course, the dance and the drama
film,
and all of that.
If you see every film of his that he's done, you could actually tell that he's really given it his 100%.
Yeah.
There was never a time I've seen any of his films where I feel like he sort of just took it lightly. I think every scene would have him perform with his 100% capacity as an actor, as a performer. And I think that's was brilliant. And he was so focused on his fitness. Like, he always, he even mentioned that you know, he never really misses the gym, and he would love, even during shoots, although it can be very exhausting,
we
that he
to
never
work out together
it.
At one point, and I see him so focused, his trainer is constantly on his case, if I could say. And in fact, Puneet would drive the trainer more than the trainer driving him. And I've seen this live through the years
that
I used to.
I think the fact that he was extremely motivated, and he was always sort of inspired to more than just being like looking good in front of a camera. I think for him it was more about the health and, you know, the fitness factor. And it's honestly, like, today the news was simply shocking.
Well, stay with us. Parul also has had a great encounter with Puneet Rajkumar. He's launched one of her songs. Parul, do take us through your fond memory of Appu today. Tragic loss.
So before I take you to what my memories with him, let me tell you, this is obviously, he is he belongs to the first family of Kannada film industry, but he himself was a huge mega star. He's somebody who did 29 movies in a leading role, and out of which 26 were super blockbusters. So you can understand the ratio of his success. He was somebody who was a great actor. He was somebody who was a fantabulous dancer. He was somebody who would do his own stunt and refused to use body double. He's somebody who would sing his own songs, and not only his song, but he is somebody who would sing song for other actors as well. So he was a very accomplished actor, I would say. He was a great producer. He would, you know, give chances to new talent. I think the recent movie he gave chance to new actors were Danish Sheth and Panaga Barna's French Biryani. And it is so nice to see somebody, such huge name, backing new talents and something which is content driven. You know, you have a huge respect for such actors. You know, my last memory, I would say, me and Ramesh sir, Ramesh Arvind sir, had gone, because Ramesh sir has directed one movie, which is a Queen remake, which we've done, called Butterfly. And he and Ramesh sir are great friends. So he obliged us by releasing one of my my song. And he was so humble. I remember when I met him last, and he was patient enough to sit and listen to the entire album. And he was, as Sharmila said, he was something who was, he was somebody who was passionate about movie making. You can see he's in producing movies, him acting and all of it. So I would say it's not only huge loss to the KFI, but the entire state. I don't know how we, as part of this industry, or the actors, or the fans, are, we won't be able to ever comprehend actually what really happened. Somebody, as you said, a fitness freak, somebody who's so young, the sudden demise is, I was just taking
it's
off
just
from
so
Bombay.
It's just so painful to hear. We're still not able to digest that news. It's still...
I cried on board for 2 hours. 2 hours I could not, and the aerostis came and he gave me, and I could not, just because you don't have to be great friends with him, but he was so humble. Nabila, you wouldn't know that, as we all know that, you know, it's very common to have a sea of fans outside a superstar's house.
No, it's but not so common. I would dispute that it's not so common. You wouldn't see stars standing outside round the clock. Appu had fans standing outside his door round the clock. They would just camp there.
No, but there's something very uncommon, Nabila. He would make sure that his fans were standing outside his bungalow are not standing hungry. He would always offer them coffee, tea, upattu, something, you know, he would not let them stay hungry. And the least he could do is he would oblige them with selfies. He would just, you know, he was so good. I think
know.
I've said this in an earlier interview, that his father said one thing, that Abhimani Galu, Devre Galu, this is what he took so seriously and understood, that your fans are God, and he treated them with so much of, you know, compassion,
no,
I would
no,
say.
I know.
He was too
on his birthday, you have fans coming in with cakes. Each fan would have a different cake with them. He would patiently sit along with each of them, cut every cake, eat with them, celebrate the entire birthday with his fans. he somehow made his fans his identity, and that's the kind of affection that they reciprocated with. Every event of Appu, they all land up. Any movie of Appu, they're all in theatres. Every single screen theatre is packed in Karnataka, any film of Appu that releases. A quick word I'll get to Indrajit Lankesh. Indrajit, you are a film director. You've, of course, come across Appu several times. The man could have easily gotten into politics with the kind of clout he held in Karnataka. A lot of requests came his way as well. He would have gotten offers from different industries, including Bollywood for that matter, every other industry in the South. But he somehow was so focused around Kannada film industry because he had a lot to give and a lot to contribute, a lot more than what his, of course, his father did a lot. But he too wanted to stay rooted to the Kannada culture so much so he did not want to get distracted at all. Never wanted to diversify outside the state.
Yeah, Nabila, actually what you said is right. Even his father, Dr. Rajkumar, as well as Puneet Rajkumar, they didn't want to divert from their kind of field, what they were focused in. In fact, as the panelists said, it's a great loss to the industry. And losing my friend, my close friend, Puneet Rajkumar, and another close friend just a few months back, Sanchari Vijay, both of them great actors, national award-winning actors, and losing them, both of them in a gap of few months, it's a great loss, not just to the Kannada industry, it's a great loss to the Indian industry. A vacuum what they have left, it's very, very hard to fill. In fact, why I'm saying his, like, you know, Puneet Rajkumar was not just a great actor. He was an amazing singer. In fact, he sang for young actors, upcoming actors who were just getting into the industry. Just lending his voice to them made a lot of difference. And apart from that, he was super dancer. And he was a complete kind of a artist, you know. If he was a director's dream. Directors like me would love to work with him. In fact, I was supposed to work with him. Rockline Venkatesh had offered me a film with Puneet Rajkumar. And it's very sad now. I can't even express in words how I feel today, because Puneet is not just an actor, a superstar, a legend in himself, just like his father, but a close and dear friend of mine. Yeah. In fact, we used to work out together there's a place called Figure and Fitness, which was run by Santosh. I think even you know it. It was run in the KC, the cricket stadium. We used to work there and do aerobics there.
And after that, he worked out at this gym called Affinity in Sadashiv Nagar, encountered him. And what a fantastic personality. But Indrajit, stay with us, because what we know now is that it's slightly disturbing to see that you have fit people like Puneet Rajkumar succumbing at such an early age. This puts, of course, on the alarming new trend of young India and its heart problems, right? Now, the proportion of under 40-year-olds getting a heart attack is, of course, rising every year. And just a few months ago, another fitness enthusiast, you had actor Siddharth Shukla, who died of a cardiac arrest. And that's why we have our doctor here to check on what exactly is to worry here. Doctor, if you can give us an insight into what you think is this rising trend of fit young individuals succumbing to a heart attack. Dr. Vivek, please take it away.
Yeah. This is actually very sad and shocking, but this is also an eye-opener for the entire society. You don't need to be old or have tight blockages or critical blockages to have a heart attack. Even young people can have heart attack if they are under a lot of stress, the dietary habits are not okay. And one thing here I would like to stress is that excessive gymming, it can make you look fit, but the stress should be on being fit than being on looking fit. So excessive exercise can lead to even minor blockages rupturing and causing total occlusion of the heart arteries, leading to a massive heart attack. Also, the gyms also provide protein supplements, which are associated with steroid mixture. And this can be very dangerous for the blockages. They can increase very drastically and lead to heart attack. So excessive gymming and unsupervised use of these protein supplements should be avoided. This is a message for the entire society that this event has given us.
Right, doctor, stay with us. I'm going to quickly cut across to Ramesh Arvind. Mr. Arvind, if you're with us, I can't fathom the fact that he was with you until the last. Just a moment, Indrajit, I'll come to you. I'll just come to you. Arvind was saying that he had a chat with Puneet until last night. Was it a late night, Arvind? Was it a late night? And you have a doctor saying here that it's an advice to people, to young individuals, not to consume any kinds of steroids or any kind of synthetics. I never knew Appu of doing any such thing. I remember him being a clean eater, a man who loved his food. He really had a weakness for food, but also exercised extensively, sans the steroids. I don't think he was someone who would resort to steroids.
Appu, I think, had a very, very clean lifestyle.
Yeah.
Even if he comes into a party, he'll be out in about half an hour to 45 minutes, be nice to everybody and go away from there. That's the way he was. He would eat very little. Yesterday, in fact, he was very particular that he wouldn't eat non-veg. He didn't eat sweets at all yesterday.
He didn't eat.
And he was looking absolutely fit. So I don't see any at all about what the doctor is saying about unsupervised is the word he used.
Mm.
I think I like that. It's about being unsupervised. As long as the supervision is right and you're taking the right stuff, which is recommended by the guys who know their stuff, it should be okay. I really don't know what Puneet was taking at all. I think that's not the point at all here. I'm surprised at the whole thing because to me, if there was something wrong with the guy in any way, there should have been a small hint of it somewhere yesterday. He was absolutely cheerful. There was not a single telltale sign that the man was ill in any way. It must have been a sudden thing which happened in the morning.
You're saying that he... how long did you all stay out late in the night?
He says he was a little uneasy last night itself.
Okay, 11:15 in the night. And
yeah.
what we hear is that last night itself, he was feeling a bit uneasy. But did you see any of that discomfort?
Not at all. He was perfectly cheerful. He was talking like we meet on any other day. In fact, it was more exciting yesterday, showing about he had shot some documentary about Karnataka forest during lockdown. And then he showed it to me and said, "Sir, I'm planning to release this." I said, "What's the story going to be?" And then I asked him, "What's the title?" He said, "The title is Gandhadagudi." Mm. Gandhadagudi was a famous film of Dr. Rajkumar,
yeah.
And he had made something based on that. I don't know what it was. That was his dream.
No, you know what? Over the years, I think Appu was someone who wanted to, he sort of wanted to help those budding stars in the industry, not just launch them in his films or in his production, but actually put money in their projects. Very few stars and actors do that today, but Appu really had faith in a lot of talents. We saw his latest films didn't do exceptionally well, at least the last one or two films, but I think he was quick to sort of understand that and put his money where it would work. He had some of the budding talents that he was already encouraging. Do we see that in other stars today? Very rarely do we see them actually come forward, help another star grow, which we saw extensively of Appu doing.
No, it happens all the time in South. It happens quite a bit in South. Mm. That happens. But what is nice about Appu was that in these films, he was not even starring in it. He was just the producer.
Yeah.
Normally, what we do is we'll have a bigger role. And we give an younger guy a smaller role in the film, perhaps to encourage and all that. What Appu was doing was that he was producing films exclusively for these youngsters. His mind was towards that. He was telling me yesterday that digital content itself is a great business, sir. He must do more stuff on digital. His mind was on that. He was intending to make more films. His wife, Ashwini, was producing all this. That was what he told me yesterday. I think they have another three films on the anvil. They planned to do something.
Yeah, he was really producing a lot of series on OTT as well. He knew that there was so much scope and potential in OTT platforms. I'm saying such a huge star that he is, very few stars have that vision. And he had that every time that you speak to him. He has this new idea and a new venture that he wants to come up with. Always buzzing with an idea or the other every time. Well, Indrajit, you were saying, you were making a point, a quick word on Appu here trying to encourage new talent, and he was unabashed about it. And he was also one star who never had enemies in the industry. I mean, there was a lot of talk about how there's an Appu camp and there's a Sudeep camp and there's this camp, that camp. But as much as the speculation was, on ground, you'd see Appu talking to Sudeep like they're brothers when they meet. Appu talking to Yash like there's really no competition. Appu talking to Upendra like he loves him. So where was any enmity at all? Appu was really Appu with everyone. Everyone loved him. There was absolutely no animosity through and through his career.
And that's because he was confident in his craft. because he was a great dancer, as I said, and he was a great singer, and he was a great actor, and he was a successful actor on his own. He stood by his own, even though he was Dr. Rajkumar's son. He made a name for himself, and he had fans across the length and breadth of not just Karnataka, in fact, South India. In fact, a lot of actors like Allu Arjun were fans of Puneet Rajkumar, which they have come out and said that openly. And as you asked me about these youngsters encouraging, one is, he used to encourage young talent. At the same time, Puneet was a very smart businessman as well. In fact, before coming to the industry, he was a successful businessman. And even now, as a producer, he was very successful. He recognized the OTT even before anybody else, so that he started making films for the online, OTT platform. So apart from that, I was just making a point about Dr. Vivek, which he did. He gave us a very, very important point. I would like to say that, because somewhere down the line, I feel so bad. I feel like crying. I'm just holding back in this program, because Puneet, losing a friend. In fact, I don't know whether you say I'm a selfish guy or whether I'm a very small thinking, whatever it is. I could have, or we could have saved Puneet. In fact, a youngster, as Dr. Vivek said, even youngsters could get cardiac arrest. Last night, after coming back from the party, in fact, he said that there's a chest pain. Mm. And if he had just gone to the doctor, in fact, we could all saved him. He was a great talent. God,
I'm just thinking of it 100 times. Yeah. I've been thinking of the same thing 100 times. When he said he complained of chest pain, he could have just possibly been taken to the doctor at that moment. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
In fact, I feel so sorry for Ashwini, who's a close friend of mine, and their daughters who have met them so many times. I feel sorry for them. Because of the failure of the entourage, I would like to say, somebody should have taken him to the hospital last night. He slept last night at home, and when he got up, he started working out, and he collapsed. And it's a negligence of the entourage, I should say. I feel so sad.
But that's the thing, right? You could really get confused with acidity, with gastric. If you're having a chest pain, you don't know what's coming your way.
As you said, across the industry, they loved him. There was no camps or no controversy as such. And no enemies as such.
Got your point.
Talent. And somewhere on the line, I feel so bad. Last night, I should
absolutely, have absolutely. I mean, hearing Ramesh Arvind say that he chatted with him for 2 hours last night. He was so chirpy and cheerful. Went back home, said he had a chest pain, went to sleep, and then woke up and went to the gym thinking that he was all okay. And then he collapsed in the gym. Well, Indrajit, thank you very much. We're a little short on time, but I don't know if our viewers know this, but Puneet Rajkumar has donated his eyes right after he passed away. In fact, he decided much long before that he wanted to donate his eyes. Right after he passed away, within an hour's time, he donated his eyes. That process happened just like his father did. Even the same process Dr. Rajkumar went through as well right after his demise. So, really, we fondly remember Appu all along.
Abhimani Devarugodu, Puneet Rajkumar has given the eyes to his fans. That's an amazing thing. I would love to say.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Indrajit. Ramesh Arvind, thank you very much for your time and joining us. Sharmila Mandre, Parul and Manjunath, really, Doctor as well, for all that insight. Puneet Rajkumar, of course, will live on in our memory. This is certainly not an end to him. His work will certainly live on. Welcome back. Shah Rukh Khan's son, Aryan Khan, will have to spend one more night in the Arthur Road jail as paperwork delayed his release. Aryan will most likely be out of jail by early tomorrow morning. In fact, actor Juhi Chawla has now given surety for Aryan's bail. Here's what awaits Aryan Khan as he gets set for his weekend release.
Hundreds waited outside the Arthur Road jail and Shah Rukh Khan's residence, Mannat, to see their hero's son, Aryan Khan, back from prison. But their hopes were dashed.
You have got the order?
Yes.
And what is the procedure now?
So we are heading towards the Man Court.
So abhi aap log Sessions Court mein? NDPS Court jayenge?
Haan, wahi log.
The exit formalities required for release from jail could not be completed by the 5:30 p.m. deadline. Now, Aryan will be released from jail on Saturday. From getting the bail order copy from the Bombay High Court to the release order, it was a hectic day for Aryan Khan's legal team. Juhi Chawla, who is the co-owner of Kolkata Knight Riders, an IPL team owned by Shah Rukh Khan, has given surety of Aryan Khan's bail.
I'm just happy that it's all over and Aryan will come home very, very soon. Aryan ghar aa jayega, iski khushi hai. And I think it's a big relief for everybody.
It was around 3:30 in the afternoon that Bombay High Court gave a 5-page operative order for the release of Aryan Khan from the Arthur Road Jail prison. Immediately, his legal team got down to work and made sure that surety Juhi Chawla came on time and the papers were completed. But in spite of their best efforts, the procedure could get completed only after 6:30, and in that time, Juhi Chawla had a field time getting clicked by the court staff.
Aryan's bail comes with riders. The High Court has set 14 conditions. Aryan cannot leave the country without court's permission. Even if he wishes to leave Mumbai, he would have to inform the NCB in advance. He would also need to mark his presence every Friday at the NCB office. And most importantly, he should not establish contact with co-accused in the drug bust case. For the Khan family, the much-awaited reunion is delayed a few hours, but comes well in time to celebrate Diwali at home. With Vidya, Mustafa and Saurabh Vakhtania in Mumbai, Bureau Report, India Today.
On that note, it's a wrap on the news track. Do stay with us. News and updates continues on the other side with Rajdeep Sardesai.